Now let's talk about video in ProPresenter 7. So you'll notice that I have two different, well, actually they're the exact same videos right here. But they, while it's the same video, they're doing two totally different things. This is a background video, so anything on the slides layer will show above it. And you'll notice this icon. This is a new icon in ProPresenter 7 that has kind of a blank slide looking thing there. And underneath it is kind of like a picture. This one has the opposite. This has a picture with a blank slide looking thing underneath it. You'll also notice that this says 5.0 and this says 0.0. So what's going on here? Well, let me show you what it does, and then I'll tell you why it does it. So, if we click on this, you'll notice that after 5 seconds, it goes to this one. If we wait on this one, you'll notice that when this bar here gets to the end, it's going to jump back here. So, 3, 2, 1, and it goes back to here. So, what's going on? Well, background videos, any slide with the background video, it ignores the duration of the slide itself when you put a go to next timer on it. So this will only play for 5 seconds. If I wanted it to play for 20 seconds, let's change the go to next timer to 20. Since this is a 17 second loop. So when it gets to that here in 3, 2, 1, now it's going to play it all the way through this, and well, it should have, since it's still a beta version. Let's make sure again. Okay, I just had to click on it again. So it plays it all the way through. 3, 2, 1, and I expect this to start over again. And that's what it did. And now it jumps to this one. So a background will continue to loop as long as the number is here. If it's set to loop, if it's set to stop, it'll just stop and stay right there. If it's set to soft loop, it'll add a cross dissolve, etc. As long as there's time on this clock, a background will do that. A foreground will play all the way through the video, and then however much time you put here, that's how long it will stay stopped until it advances. So normally zero is what you want, but occasionally things are odd and you don't want that. So let me clear those. Those are two of the ways you can add videos. It is also the case, right click, edit slide, that you can add a video on the slides layer itself. So if I have this slide and I click media, I can find a video and I can put it on the slides layer. So here is this. Oh, that's actually going to take it a second. Let's see if I've got one that I've already downloaded. Yeah, so there's my unboxing video from, okay, low res, thank you Facebook. But if we go back to show, I've got that here. Let me make sure that I have this muted. Okay, that should be muted. And so this will play 20 seconds of me doing this, and then after 20 seconds, it will go to the next one. We still have the issue that this video isn't the, that's not where this is advancing. But you also notice that every time I change from one slide to another, what's on the slides layer stops or starts over if it's on the slides layer. If it's not on the slides layer, then it doesn't. So that's something to keep in mind. I'm using three different ways of dealing with video. It is possible to put video on the props layer as well. So, file, actually, silly me, it's right here, props editor. So, I can add media on the props layer. Let's see if I can find the one. Let's see what that is. It's not exactly what I wanted. Let me go back to show and let's see if we can't find where that is. Show in Finder. So here that is. Now let's go back into the props layer. And let's go into Finder here and let's put that there. Okay. So that's obviously huge, much bigger than I actually want it. So let's shrink that down. To, let's say, like that. And that was a typo I made a while back. And let's resize this to screen 2. Yeah, and if I do this. Okay. Oops. Let's go back to show. Now, let's add an action. I almost said cue. Go into the action palette. They used to be called cues in Pro 6. And I'm going to add a prop. So the prop I want is prop 1. So when we get there, I expect to see that little video show up in this upper right hand corner. So that should happen. And it's probably, again, the same issue that I had before where I had to click on it again. Yep, there we go. So it's right there. So those are some of the different ways that I can add video. I can add it as a foreground video, as a background video, on the slides layer, or even on the props layer. And if I put it on the props layer, it will stay up. So you'll notice the text here was added here and continued to stay up, because props will stay up until they're removed. So I could add an action here to clear that, or whatever. So those are all the different ways that you're most likely to work with video in ProPresenter 7.